In this lecture, we will discuss about Hayes bridge. Basically, it is used for the measurement of self-inductance. It is the modification of Maxwell bridge. But the main difference between Maxwell bridge and Hayes bridge is that in Maxwell bridge, we use a parallel combination of resistance and capacitance over this R of bridge. But in Hayes bridge, we use series combination of resistance and capacitance like this. This is the series combination of resistance and capacitance over a particular arm of this bridge. So this is the main difference between Hayes bridge and Maxwell bridge. Now, as we know that every bridge consists of four arms, similarly it also has consist of four arms: AB, BC, CD, DA. Each arm consists of impedances like Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. Z1 is unknown impedance, while Z2, Z3 and Z4 are known impedances. To determine the value of unknown impedance, as we have the balanced equation of AC bridge, Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3. Now, first, we have to determine the value of impedances over these four arms. At arm AB, we have unknown impedance L1 having resistance R1. Unknown impedance L1 having resistance R1. Okay? Then, if we calculate the value of Z1, impedance Z1 is equals to, it will be equal to R1 plus j omega L1. Similarly, arm BC has a non-inductive resistance R3. So the value of impedance Z3 will be equal to R3. Over arm CD, it has a standard capacitor C4, it is connected in series with resistance R4. Capacitor C4, resistance R4, both are connected in series. So the value of impedance Z4 is equals to R4 plus XC. The reactance of capacitance is equals to, on solving this value, R4 plus 1 upon j omega C4, where 1 upon j can be written as minus j. So Z4 is equals to R4 minus j upon omega C4. Arm DA includes a non-inductive resistance R2. So the value of impedance Z4 will be equal to R2. So the value of Z1 will equal to R1 plus j omega L1, Z2 is equals to R2, Z3 is equals to R3, and Z4 impedance is equals to R4 minus j upon omega C4. As we have the general balance equation of impedances of AC bridge, Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3, Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3. So on putting the value of impedances in this equation, we will get the value of Z1, R1 plus j omega L1, the value of Z4, R4 minus j upon omega C4 is equals to Z2, R2, Z3, R3. So on solving these values, we will get, by opening these brackets and solving, R1 R4 minus J R1 upon omega C1 by multiplying R1 in this bracket, plus by solving this with this bracket content, J omega L1 R4 plus L1 upon C4 is equals to R2 R3. Further solving these values, R1 R4 plus L1 C4 plus J omega L1 R4 is equals to R2 R3 plus J R1 upon omega C4. So on comparing the real and imaginary part, R1 R4 plus L1 upon C1 is equals to R2 R3 from real part. Similarly, from imaginary part, we will get R1 is equals to omega square L1 R4 C4. This is equation number first and this is equation number second. Put the value of R1 in equation first, from equation second. This value of R1 we will put into equation first. We will get omega square L1 R4 C4 plus L1 upon C1 is equals to R2 R3. Okay. Now solving this equation, we will get the value of L1, that will be equal to R2 R3 C4 upon 1 plus omega square R4 square C4 square. This is the equation number third. On putting the value of L1 in equation second, we will get the value of R1. R1 will equals to omega square C4 square R2 R3 R4 upon 1 plus omega square C4 square R4 square. This is nothing but by solving the calculation on putting the value of L1 in this equation, C equation number second. Okay, the simple equation. Now we have to determine the value of quality factor. As we know that the definition of quality factor says that it is the ratio of inductive reactance to the effective resistance, that is omega L1 upon R1. So by putting the value of L1 from equation third and by putting the value of R1 by this value, we will get the value of quality factor, that will be equals to 1 upon omega C4 R4. So this is all about Hayes bridge.